Jag, I would suggest you may not want to start your car with jumper cables. However, as we look at this, we tried to start the car and we plugged everything up the right kind of way. The red was on red, the black was on black. The car was hooked up exactly the way it was supposed to be, and I don't know about you, but we've got a church mother that knows how to be a mechanic as well. She did all that she could do to help me start my car, and I'm familiar with starting cars as well, so I know that she was doing the right thing in assisting me in this whole process. As she assisted me and she plugged my car in, she says, "Now go and turn your ignition on." And I turned my ignition on and my car still would not start. She says, "Stop right here." And then she says, "Let's try it again." And my car still didn't start. Now, we had done everything that we were supposed to do in trying to get my car to start. Everything, we followed the directions carefully. If we were to call someone else, they would have told us the same thing to do. And it seemed that the situation was not getting any better. Certainly, it was getting worse. Because as we were trying to start our car, as energy was trying to be passed on from one car to the next car, it seemed that a fire had broken out on those jumper cables. And as the fire began to, I'm just trying to lay the introduction to my message. And as the fire began to roar, I began to run around with my crazy self. And I was asking people to call the ambulance when they should have been calling the fire truck. And as I looked and as I was getting ready, as I was getting nervous and getting scared about starting my car, I looked around and there was Mother Smith sitting on a log, just chilling. She wasn't doing anything. The fire was going and she was chilling, and I'm trying to figure out what in the world is going on. And so she says, "Pastor, it's going to be all right. I can get a new pair of jumper cables," and I'm screaming, "but the car is on fire." And she's saying, "Pastor, it's all right. Taisha and all them are hanging around. Everybody, nobody's losing it but me." And actually, we got the fire out. The cables came off. And still, my car had not started. I said to myself, "Well, I guess I might have to go to a car dealership or find somewhere to get me a new one or something, because my car is just not starting." She says, "Just wait a few seconds. Your car is going to eventually start." And I'm saying, "No, the jumper cables caught on fire, whatever." And out of the blue, the car came on. It is interesting now, believers, that as we look at our lives and as we try to do everything that we seemingly can do to make our lives work, to make our situations a little bit better, we do everything the right way. We do everything the right. We do it at the right minute. We do it at the we prepare the way that we should prepare. And sometimes it seems like in all of our preparation, it seems like our car still will not start. Am I talking to anybody in here? You went to school, you took taking the classes that you were supposed to take, you put the money where it was supposed to be, you paid your tithes the way you were supposed to, you prayed like you were supposed to, you did what God told you to do, and it still seemed like there's some things that won't come together. Am I talking to anybody in here today? I'm talking about, and maybe many of you might not be able to relate, but where I'm going and what I'm trying to tap into is probably one of the most frustrating experiences that a person could ever have. When you know that you've done everything you were supposed to do, but still don't have it all together.
Come on, preacher.
Am I talking to y'all in here today?
Yeah.
But when you know that you've dotted every T, that you've crossed every I, that you've crossed every T, that you've dotted every I, and still deal, it's not together. Yeah. And I preach it here today. That when you know that you have tried every instant, you tried every moment to work some things out, and the working still did not come together. Maybe I'm the only one in here who has ever experienced frustrating times and frustrating situations in which I gave my all, but I still didn't have enough. I feel like preaching it here today. Touch a neighbor and say, I gave it all, but I still didn't have enough. See, the interesting thing about it is, can I preach it here today? Most of the time, our all only brings us about three-fourths of the way to our destiny when there's still one-fourth to go. Can I preach it here today? Somebody say, I went three-fourths, but I still got one-fourth to go. It seems that the most frustrating thing is when you've reached the end of your three-fourths and don't have enough strength, don't have enough money, don't have enough things to get the rest of the way. When your destiny was not in the three-fourths, your destiny is you going the full way. Can I talk to y'all in here? Somebody say three-fourths versus one-fourth. The question that I want to pose to y'all this morning, I'm sorry, but I want to pose a question that will cause you to search yourself is, what happens when life comes short? Ask your neighbor, what happens when life comes short? It is the question that many of us try to overlook, we try to pass by, because we really don't want to ask the question. And the truth be told, many of our lives and many instances and circumstances, our lives have simply come up short. Can I preach it here today? We don't have enough skill. We don't have enough power. We don't have enough tenacity. We don't have enough strength to make it the rest of the way. As a matter of fact, some of you are questioning how you got this far. God. Some of you are questioning how you made it this much. How is it that you're sitting in church this morning when you should be somewhere out in the street, somewhere, with a piece of rope tied around your arm and a needle in your... Y'all ain't talking to me. When you should be overdosing on something. Some of you are questioning why you made it this far. Ask your neighbor, how you get here? How you get here? I don't know about you, but there have been some moments in my life where I say, God, I've done everything that I should. I've done everything that I know to do. I've been obedient to you, but I'm still coming up short. Oh, can I preach here today? Touch a neighbor and say, I was that one. I came up short sometimes. Is there anybody in here that has ever came up short? I dare you to shout hallelujah at this. Here now, it is interesting that preparation is key, but preparation a lot of times is not everything. I'm going to say it one more time. Preparation is key, but preparation a lot of times is not everything. As a matter of fact, we got some teachers here and some former teachers here. And sometimes before you go to the first day of school, a lot of times the teacher prepares her classroom or his classroom, and he makes sure that the bulletin boards are up. He makes sure that the construction paper is properly there. He makes sure that the names of the children are on the desk. He or she makes sure that all of the things are in line, sometimes spending the school's money. And a lot of times you have to go beyond that and you got to spend your own money. But and it looks like during the summertime, as you prepare and as you reach that first day of school, once you get to the first day of school, you still seem like there's some things that are missing, some things that you got to put together. As a matter of fact, some of you have attempted to open up your own business, and you put things together, and you put things here and there, and you made proper preparation so that that business can open up and so that it can be successful. And then when you reach your first day of business, everything is in place, everything is in line, but you don't have any customers. Y'all ain't talking to me any today. God, you've got everything in place. You sell fragrance. You got all the fragrances. You got all of the soaps. You got everything together. You got the money, you've got the register, you got everything, but one thing you don't have to make that thing successful is the customers. Y'all ain't talking to me here today. There's some things that you don't have any, that you cannot have control over. You've got to understand that there's some places and some spaces, even though you put everything together, there's some still some things that you're going to come up short.
short in. Am I talking to anybody in here? Ask your neighbor, have you ever come up short?